ऑफ सब्जेक्ट साइंस वन. आई एम अमृता धाड़गे फ्रॉम खेरनगर म्युनिसिपल सेकेंडरी इंग्लिश मीडियम स्कूल. एंड वी फ्रॉम लास्ट थ्री सेशंस वी आर डिस्कसिंग द टॉपिक रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ लाइट. टुडे वी विल रिकॉल ऑल इट्स कंसेप्ट एज वेल एज वी विल लर्न टू न्यू टॉपिक्स टुडे, टू न्यू कंसेप्ट फ्रॉम दिस लेसन टुडे. सो लेट्स प्रोसीड. We started from the simple concept of mirrors, which we are using in our day-to-day life, and a simple activity, a fond activity of us standing in front of the mirror and watching us. Okay, so we started this lesson with this day-to-day life activity, and we related this activity to all the diagrams of the plane mirrors. So what were these mirrors? We need polished surfaces for reflecting light, and these polished surfaces are present at our homes by the name mirrors. Okay, so this is because polished surface absorb less light, and so maximum light gets reflected. In scientific language, a surface which reflects light and creates clear images is called a mirror. These are the types of mirrors: plane mirrors and spherical mirrors. The plane mirrors are the mirrors which we use in our homes. You can see the concave and convex mirrors. We studied this diagram for rays falling on the mirror at a normal surface. So two important things we studied in this from this phenomenon, that is incident ray and reflected ray both travel along a same path. Okay, and here we studied the reflection for a point source. So two things we concluded over here. First one was light travels in all directions from a source, and that the point is the image of the point source. Okay, so if your object is a point, the image is also a point. After this, we studied this diagram. When the reflected rays, they do not actually meet, but when we extend them behind the mirrors, the dotted lines were the extended lines, we get an image and we feel like the image is forming behind the mirror. So that those images are called as virtual images. Then this was for the image formation of an extended point source. Okay, so we took a full object, which is a pen, and a virtual image of this object is formed behind the mirror. You can see the size of the object and size of the image is same. Then we studied lateral inversion of all the alphabets. In that, we also studied that some alphabets do not follow lateral inversion. Okay, this was the best example of lateral inversion. We never write the word ambulance as it is. We write it from left to right. Okay, so that we can read the word ambulance in the convex mirror of a car. Now, lateral inversions also happens in the images. When you raise right hand in front of the mirror, it appears as if you are raising the left hand in the image. Now, then this was a very important concept, that in order to see the full image of a person standing in front of the mirror, the minimum height of the mirror must be half the height of the person. Okay, so we do not have long mirrors. Small mirrors can also give us the view of the whole object standing in front of it. Now, these were the examples of concave mirror and convex mirror. Solar furnace is a very important example of concave mirror, whereas the side mirrors of vehicle is the example of convex mirror. Now, we studied all the terms related to spherical mirrors, which were very important while studying the reflected rays diagram. What we did, we simulated this diagram to the concept of circle, which we use in maths. The C, which is called a center of curvature over here. Okay. F is called as principal focus. P is called as pole of the mirror. Now we are having two radius of this circle, CA and CP. Both are the radius of curvature. Now, what is the focal length? The distance between principal focus and pole of the mirror is called as focal length. What is principal axis? A straight line passing through center of curvature and pole of the mirror is called as principal axis. Merely by seeing the diagram, you should be able to identify the names as well as their definitions so that you can implement them in the numericals, in the problems which we have to solve based on the spherical mirrors, concave mirrors and convex mirrors. Now, yesterday, I was talking verbally about this, that how you should draw a concave mirror or a convex mirror. Okay, now, here I have displayed a diagram. You can see that the CFP are equidistant. The distance between CF is 3 cm and FP is also 3 cm. Okay, so yesterday I was trying to explain this, and today with the help of this diagram, with this figure, it will be very clear how to draw a spheric concave mirror or a convex mirror. Okay. So, just draw a straight line first. Place a scale on it. Place your 0 cm markings at C. Okay. And if you take F at 3 cm, place the point P at 6 cm. If you take F at 4 cm, place point P at 8 cm. I hope you people are understanding. Because when you follow these measurements, whatever object's image you will get, those will be as per the scientific tables which are given to us. And you can draw those images very easily. This is for concave mirror. What will happen for convex mirror? F will remain as it is. Okay. In place of P, you will write C. Just the center of curvature is going to change. And the curve which is placed on P will be placed on C. These were the three rules. Ray of light which is parallel to the principal axis after reflection passes through the focus F. Okay, so when you follow these measurements, you can see that you can draw these diagrams very easily. Second was ray of light passing through the center of the curvature is reflected back along the same path. Okay, so you can see a single line which is passing through C, that is center of curvature, which is having incident ray and reflected ray itself on it. Rule 3 is ray of light passing through the focus after reflection becomes parallel to the principal axis. See, the incident ray is passing through capital F and it is parallel to the principal axis. Now, these were the cases for concave mirrors. You can see when the object is placed beyond the center of curvature, okay, it is behind C. So it is beyond the center of curvature. You get the image which is inverted, which is real, as the two rays are intersecting each other. And which rules do these case follow? They follow rule number one, that is when the incident ray is parallel to the principal axis, the reflected ray passes through the focus. And when the incident ray passes through the center of curvature, the reflected ray travels along the same path. Okay, wherever we write the name of the object as AB, the image will be B dash A dash. As B is on principal axis, the point B dash will be on the principal axis. Case 2, if a object is at center of curvature, you can see the object is at C itself, that is at the center of curvature, exactly at the center of curvature. You can see first incident ray passing through the head of the object is parallel to the principal axis. So the reflected ray passes through F. Second incident ray passes through F and is parallel to the principal axis. Now, wherever these two incident rays meet, okay, we can highlight dark the point of intersection. And you can see that the image is obtained just below the principal axis. This image is also inverted and real. You can see this is the third case. Object is between C and F, that is center of curvature and focal length and principal focus. Okay, you can see that the incident ray parallel to the principal axis passes through F and the incident ray which passes through the center of curvature, the reflected ray travels along the same path. So the image is formed beyond the center of curvature, which is real, inverted, and magnified. You can see that the height of person changes. So it is magnified. Case 4 was object is at F. The person is standing at F. You can see the incident ray passing through the head of the person. It is parallel to the principal axis, hence it passes through F, that is principal focus. The incident ray passing through the center of curvature. So the reflected ray travels along the same path. And these two reflected rays are parallel. They never meet each other. So when the object is at F, the image will be formed at infinity, okay? The image will be formed at infinity, but the image will be real and inverted and highly magnified. Object is between F and P, that is principal focus and pole. You can see that the object is magnified. You can view the person in its enlarged view, so it is magnified. You can see the head of the person is pointing upwards, both for the object and the image. So they are erect. And as the extended rays are meeting together, and then we are getting the image, so the image is virtual, as it is formed behind the mirror. Now, this was the formulation of the chart. This is very important chart. So I am repeating it. When the position of the object is between pole and focus, position of the image is behind the mirror. erect, virtual and magnified. As you travel from the center of curvature towards the pole, okay, you get a magnified image, erect, virtual, magnified image. At focus, at infinity. This diagram I have shown you before, that when a person stands at focus, the image is at infinity, inverted, real, very large. Between focus and center of curvature, beyond the center of curvature, inverted, real, magnified. When the position of the object is at the center of curvature, you get the image at the center of curvature itself. Okay? Yes, the image is inverted, it is real, and same size is same as that of the object. Beyond the center of curvature, between the center of curvature and focus. Okay? When it is when the object is placed beyond C, you get the image in between C and F. It is inverted, real, and diminished. When the object is placed at a very large infinite distance, you get its image at focus. Nature of the image is inverted, real, and size of the image is point image. Okay, this was the concept of convergence and divergence. So concave mirror is the converging mirror and convex mirror is the diverging mirror. Okay, so to remember that, see, in concave mirror, while writing the spelling, you have double C, C-O-N-C-A-V-E. So you write C two times. So concave mirror can be memorized as they follow convergence. As C is appearing two times in its name, concave. Okay, you can remember that it follows or it undergoes the phenomenon of convergence, while convex mirror follows divergence. We studied it that concave mirrors, when the incident ray passes on the concave mirror, the reflected rays converge at a single point F. And which rule do they follow? They follow the rule that when an incident ray is parallel to the principal axis, the reflected ray passes through the focus. You can see the same phenomenon of convex in the convex mirror for divergence. All the reflected rays are spread. Uses of concave mirrors in barber shop, dental hospital, to have clear and magnified view of the objects. Okay, so if the object is placed between the pole and focus of the mirror, an erect, virtual and magnified image is obtained. This we have studied in the table. Okay, if we place the object between pole and focus, where do we get its image, or the nature of the image is an erect, virtual and magnified image is obtained. Torch and headlamps of the vehicles. The source of light is kept at the focus of the mirror. Thus, a parallel beam of light is obtained. Floodlights, the sources of light is placed a little beyond the center of curvature of the mirror. This gives a bright beam of light. So you can see that by using the table, that is the position of the object and the position of the image and the nature of the image, how we are getting those images can be used in such equipments which we use in our day-to-day life. Try to simulate those diagrams in our day-to-day life so that it will be easy for you to remember . Okay, so various equipments using solar energy, sun rays reflected by a concave mirror come together in a focal plane. Uses of convex mirror, mirrors on the sides of cars are convex mirrors. Big convex mirrors are fitted at gate and in square. why they are fitted in gate or in a square? So that they can see. Just remember the side mirrors of the car and the words written on it. Images in the mirror appear to be far closer than they are. Okay. So if the person it is at long distance or it is far away from the gate, the watchman is able to see it. Now we are going to study the image formed by a convex mirror. Yesterday we had 6 cases to study the images formed for a concave mirror, but for convex mirror we are going to study only one. First try to see the diagram, observe the diagram very properly. Here the mirror or the spherical mirror is changed, its side is changed. Okay. First, try to figure out the terms related to spherical mirrors. C, F and P. Center of curvature is at the right side. Then you will have F and then P. Just the location of center of curvature and pole of the mirror is changed. Okay. We will use the same method for drawing this mirror also. That is, we will place C, F, P equidistant from each other. And by placing the steel end of our compass on C, we will draw the curve at P. That will be the CP will be the radius in your compass. Okay. Now, as we were placing the objects at C for concave mirrors, but for convex mirrors, we are going to place the objects before P, that is pole of the mirror. You can see AB is the object which is in front of P. Okay. Now you can see from A, an incident ray passes, which is AQ. The second incident ray is AR. Okay, they both are extended and we get an image which is A dash B dash. Now by merely seeing this diagram, you can observe that the height of AB and height of A dash B dash in proportion, you can see that A dash B dash is smaller than the object. So the image size is smaller than that of the object. Image is virtual, as the extended, we have made those lines extended and then we are formulating the image. It is behind the mirror. Okay. So this is the virtual mirror, small in size and erect. So we will go through the lines. The nature of the image formed by a convex mirror does not depend on the distance of the object from the mirror. These images are always virtual, smaller than the object and situated behind the mirror. The nature of the image formed by a convex mirror does not depend on the distance of the object from the mirror. These images are always virtual, smaller than the object and situated behind the mirror. We have to study the Cartesian sign conventions for this mirror diagram also. We have studied the lesson coordinate geometry in which we draw x-axis and y-axis. We have learned first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, okay, fourth quadrant. And we know that the right-hand side of the x-axis from the origin towards all the right-hand side is positive. So So the arrows are placed horizontally, you can see, from the origin to the right, distances on the right are positive. Okay, from the origin to the left, distances on the left are negative. Distances upwards, from the origin upwards, they are positive. From the origin downwards, they are negative. Just simulate your coordinate geometries. X, Y axis diagram over here, and the mirror is placed at the origin. So according to the Cartesian sign conventions, the pole of the mirror is taken at the origin. So P will always lie at the origin. The principal axis is taken as the x-axis of the frame of reference. What is principal axis? A straight line passing through the center of curvature and pole of the mirror is called as principal axis. So the principal axis will be x-axis of the frame of reference. Now, what are the sign conventions which we are going to use? The object is always kept on the left of the mirror. Okay. So left side is negative. Always on the left of the mirror. All distances parallel to the principal axis are measured from the pole of the mirror. All distances measured towards the right of the pole are taken to be positive, while those measured towards the left are taken to be negative. Distances measured vertically upwards from the principal axis are taken to be positive, and distances measured vertically downwards from the principal axis are taken to be negative. The focal length of the concave mirror is negative, while that of the convex mirror is positive. This is very important sentence. Focal length is distance between principal focus and pole. That is called as small f focal length. Okay, so it is negative for concave mirror and positive for convex mirror. Now these are formulas which will be required for solving the numericals related to this topic. We get the correct values of distances by using the Cartesian sign conventions. The object distance small u is the distance of the object from the pole, while the image distance v is the distance of the image from the pole. The relationship between the object distance, image distance, and the focal length f is called the mirror formula. This formula is valid for all spherical mirrors, that is concave as well as convex mirrors, for all position of objects under all circumstances. Okay, it is simple formula, 1 upon v plus 1 upon u is equal to 1 upon f. F is the focal length, u is the object distance from the pole, and v is the image distance from the pole. Magnification due to spherical mirrors. The magnification due to spherical mirrors is given by the ratio of the height of image h2. Yes, magnification means increase in the height. Okay, the image is enlarged, so its height increases. Height of the image h2 to the height of the object h1. This tells us how large the image is as compared to the object. So magnification formula is very easy to remember. That is height of the image divided by height of the object. So height of the image is denoted by h2 divided by h1. From this, it can be shown that capital M is equal to minus v upon u. As the object is always kept above the principal axis, its height is always taken to be positive. Yes, above, vertically above the principal axis, it is positive. Okay, for virtual images, the height is positive, while for real images, it is negative. Okay, as we will find the images beyond the mirrors, and when the pole of the mirror is placed at origin. And if it goes beyond the mirror, it goes on the right side. Okay, so right side, the sign conventions, according to sign conventions, it is negative. As the object is kept on the left of the mirror, the distance u is always negative. the left side of the x-axis is negative. Therefore, the distance u is always negative. Now, this is the solved example in the textbook. We will just go through it. Rashri wants Rajashri wants to get an inverted image of height 5 cm of an object kept at a distance of 30 cm from a concave mirror. The focal length of the mirror is 10 cm. At what distance from the mirror should she place the screen? What will be the type of the image and what is the height of the object? Okay, type of the image and height of the object. Two things are asked. So first we will write all the things which are given. That is focal length f equals to minus 10 cm. Object distance u is equal to minus 30 cm. Height of the image h2 is equals to minus 5 cm. Image distance v is equal to question mark. We have to find it. Height of the object h1 equals to question mark. Okay. So by using the first formula, mirror formula, 1 upon v plus 1 upon u equals to 1 upon f, we will find out the value for v. Okay, and then we will substitute it in the magnification formula and we will find out h1. So what all known things are there that we have to substitute in the given formula. Now, as we have to find 1 upon v, we will keep 1 upon v as it is on left hand side of the equation and rest all will be transferred to the right hand side of the equation. According to the signs changed, 1 upon f, it is plus 1 upon u. When it is transferred to right hand side, it becomes minus 1 upon u. Now, they have just substituted the values of f and u. It is 1 upon minus 10 minus 1 upon minus 30. Now we have to make the denominator same as they are 10 and 30. So in tens table, when we multiply 10 by 3, we get the answer 30. So we will multiply 3 to its numerator and denominator also. So in the numerator, we will get 3. Minus sign of the denominator they have taken upwards. For second fraction, minus 30 is there. Minus minus becomes plus. As the denominators are same, you can add the numerators, which is minus 3 plus 1. And we get the answer minus 2 upon 30. When on further simplification, minus 2 upon 30 is simplified to 1 upon minus 15. And the value of v is equal to minus 1 upon 15. As the v is in denominator, okay, we will take its reciprocal and we get the value v is equal to minus 15. We will substitute this value of v in the formula of magnification. Magnification capital M is equals to h2 upon h1, which is equals to minus v upon u. Now what we have to find? We have to find h1. Okay. So cross multiplying, we get u into h2 upon v. Minus sign as it is for the given fraction. Just substitute the values. U is minus 30, h2 is minus 5, v is minus 15. 30, you can simplify 15, 1 is 15 and 15, 2 is 30. Okay, so it becomes minus 2, minus 5. The minus sign in the numerator and the denominator gets cancelled and only the minus sign of the upper two values are left, that is minus 2 and minus 5. So by multiplying it, and minus minus becomes plus, so h1 equals to 10 centimeter. As the distance is never negative, according to sign conventions, we have to take it negative, but we never write distance as negative. So they have written Rajeshri has to place the screen 15 centimeter to the left of the mirror. Okay. And for magnification, the answer is the height of the object is 10 centimeter. Thus the image will be real and diminished. We will see another example. A 10 centimeter long stick is kept in front of a concave mirror having focal length of 10 centimeter in such a way that the end of the stick closest to the pole is at the distance of 20 centimeter. What will happen? What will be the length of the image? Okay, so as it is, we will follow the same rule. First, we will write all the given things, then what we have to find, then the formulas which we are going to use, and then we will solve. So first, focal length small f is given, which is 10 centimeter. Object size h1 is equal to 10 centimeter. Object distance u is equal to 20 centimeter. Okay. Now the focal length, that is fp, is 10 centimeter. Distance from f to p is 10 centimeter. Object size h1, this object size, that is height of this object AB, is 10 centimeter. Object distance from the pole is 20 centimeter. Yes, this 10 centimeter plus this 10 centimeter, object distance is 20 centimeter. Okay, so what we have to find? We have to find length of the image h2. Both the formulas we have to use. First, mirror formula, 1 upon v plus 1 upon u is equal to 1 upon f. And then magnification formula, which is h2 upon h1 equals to minus v upon u. By using the mirror formula, now I have substituted this, minus 1 upon 20 plus 1 upon v equals to minus 1 upon 10. I have to find the value for 1 upon v. So just transfer this minus 1 upon 20 over here, which becomes positive on right hand side. 1 upon 20 minus 1 upon 10. Make the denominator same. Okay. So you will get it 1 minus 2. The answer is minus 1 upon 20. Okay. Reverse it, as we want V in the numerators. V equals to minus 20 centimeter. H2 upon H1 is equal to minus V upon U. H2 upon 10 is equals to minus 20 upon 20, minus 20, both minus, okay, so we get the answer h2 equals to minus 10 centimeter. As both of these gets cancelled, this is in denominator, it gets transferred over here in the numerator, and we get h2 equals to minus 10 centimeter. The height or length of the image is 10 centimeter. Okay, so the object is placed at the center of curvature. Therefore, the length of the h1 is also 10 centimeter and h2 is also 10 centimeter. Just the h2 is below the principal axis, so it is having sign as minus 10. Just try to simulate to the Cartesian sign conventions. H1 is above the principal axis. So vertically upwards, this is positive. So you are having the size of the object as 10 centimeter, whereas the height of the image is minus 10 centimeter, as it is below the principal axis. I have written distance upwards are positive and distance downwards are negative. One more example we will see. This is for convex mirror. Now you can see for convex mirror, C, F and P. okay, the pole of the mirror is on left side. A convex mirror of focal length, (18 centimeters), the image of an object kept in front of the mirror is half of the height of the object. Convex lens always produces images which has the height as half of that of the object. What is the distance of the object from the mirror? Okay, so what things are given to us? Focal length f equals to 18 centimeter. Image size h2 equals to half object size h1. Okay, just we have formulated it in terms of equation. That is, image size is equals to half of the object size. So image size is denoted by h2 and object size is denoted by h1. So h2 is equals to 1 upon 2 h1. What we have to find object distance u. We are going to use both the formulas, that is mirror formula as well as magnification formula. 1 upon v plus 1 upon u equals to 1 upon f. And magnification formula equals to h2 upon h1, which is equal to minus v upon u. h2 is equal to 1 upon 2 h1. h2, so you can see the formulation. h2 is on left side. h1 is in numerator. Okay, when it is transferred to left side, h2 upon h1 equals to 1 upon u. 1 upon 2. Okay. In place of h2 and h1, they have just written v upon u. So minus v upon u equals to 1 upon 2. So v is equals to minus u upon 2. Now, by using the mirror formula, 1 upon v plus 1 upon u equals to 1 upon f. 1 upon v. Okay. So v is minus u upon 2, but what you have to write 1 upon v. So you will take reciprocal of your right hand side. Okay, it will become minus 2 upon u. Plus 1 upon u equals to 1 upon f. You can see that the denominators are same. So you can add or subtract the numerators. Minus plus becomes minus, sign of greater number. So minus 2 minus 1 is 1. Sign of greater number is minus. So minus 1 upon u equals to minus 1 upon 18. Minus minus sign is there on both the sides. So it gets cancelled. U equals to 18. We have just taken the reciprocal of it. So u equals to 18 centimeter. So the distance of the object is 18 centimeter. That is, it is kept on focus. So students, keep on revising these diagrams, as these diagrams will help you in solving the problems. Ray diagrams are very important in this topic. Only two formulas are given for the numericals. If you understand the Cartesian sign conventions, you will understand all those numericals based on this chapter. This chapter is very easy only if you practice all the ray diagrams. To make it easier, try to simulate all the things to our day-to-day life. Try to visualize it, how convergence and divergence happen. This will help you in understanding this chapter very well. Okay, so this is all for a reflection of light. I hope you people must have learned the concept as well as enjoyed learning these concepts. Have a blissful day. Thank you.